Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to another Level Up with Aaron video. Here I'm doing a little bit of live gameplay for you. I'm gonna look at a few replays on offense and defense, and then I'm gonna help out and assist my clan here and clan alliance, as well as get a few attacks in and see if we can get some assists in here. So here we are. We're defending AJ's base. I think he's in the top. Well, for sure, top 50. And he's being attacked by Phoenix right now. And see, Phoenix is kind of doing a slow roll strategy here with the ranged gods, and the tanky god of Zeus kind of at the front line while they charm and control all the adds and summon a bunch of extra troops here with Hades. We do have 8 people defending AJ's base, which is a great amount of help. All it takes is one mistake with this many adds on here, and then the game will be over. Like, you see Hades is dying right here, and he hasn't pulled him out. Yep, there goes Hades. So that's a big hurt for him. So now he's really going to be in trouble. We've got a ton of troops just coming at him. He's already on the defensive, kind of scrambling. I think he's going to try to go around and get the Apollo temple over here, kind of avoid the death trap right there that's centered around the Artemis temple. But if he's not careful, I think these adds will be able to cut him off and not let him get that. He's gonna have to do quite a good amount of damage to get the Apollo down, since it's a high level temple, as you can tell from the gold roof. Also, all of the surrounding houses are really high level. So he's trying to go in for the finish here, but he's, overwhelmed, and that's pretty much game over right there. Oh, he gets a few last minute charm off, and he's getting a couple support troops. But yeah, that's game over. 0 out of 7 gods left. So, and AJ still had three out of six temples up. So that was a good defense. I'm looking for that other temple. I don't know. And I think the game just froze on me. Oh yeah, there it is, right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave that battle. Next, we'll see what we got here. I'm gonna show you a replay real quick. I'll just show you my latest defensive replay versus Pooh. Had one defender and he had 3 assisters. So the idea of the base, I'm kind of using an adaption. A lot of people, take a baseline idea and then kind of adapt it. So I know Jersey had this. I don't know if he got it from somebody else, but this theme of the Artemis houses stacked in the middle here, with the Archimedes towers, really gives you coverage on the whole base. It's a great kind of anti-ads, as well as anti-everything, because these towers, once they're stacked like that with the Ares houses, they do a ton of damage. So here he's going in. He took out the Athena temple, which is a good idea. I mean, the Apollo. He's going for the yeah, he took out the Athena temple, dropped the health of all the other temples. This is a good idea. I think he stayed in here a little bit too long, especially with his Ares. Should have pulled him out a lot sooner and might have been able to salvage him. So you can see all of the adds are coming in, and pops Hawkstorm to deal with them. I got the 3 across here and then the 3 temples down here. I also want to give credit to Gaming with Nick. I actually looked at his, and this was pretty much very similar to his. I do have a few minor tweaks on it to take advantage of a few things I think strategically might be beneficial. I'll talk about those after the replay here. So here he's skirting, added a bunch of adds. He's got, let's see, how many gods left? Oh, you can't tell in the replay, but Ares is down for sure. I'm assuming he probably has 6 gods. And his Apollo is almost dead here. Okay, he charmed off the troops, the adds off of him. Now he's still got to deal with these Archimedes towers, because they're buffed with that range. So if he tries to get in anywhere close, he's going to get burned here. So he's going to come around here and kind of try to open up from the side away from the Archimedes towers. I do have a nicely, decently upgraded Afro monument over here. So, as he's charming troops and troops are adding, that monument's doing a good job of kind of eliminating his extra helpers here. And here, so Zeus almost went down. So here he is, he's charming, like I said, trying to clear out the space. I'm surprised he didn't go for the Apollo, but I think he's trying to skirt all the adds here, because if he stands still for too long, they're gonna take him down quick. Here he went in, kind of went in for the kill. I think he, and then this is when it got ugly. He lost Apollo there, but and he almost lost Zeus and Afro, but he managed to pull him out just in time, and I think the assisters saved him there with their spawns just in the nick of time. He's gonna go back in and try to go for the Apollo temple here, but he doesn't have a lot of DPS with these characters that are left on here. Afro, Athena, and Zeus, they have decent damage, but no real nuke damage, so he's got to, run the risk of staying in range of sustained damage from the Archimedes towers. So it's pretty dangerous. It's going to be pretty hard to finish off at this point. Here we go. He's trying to make it last. I'm going to speed it up. You pretty much get the idea here. I think it's a slowly inevitable loss until once the troops start to stack up and you lost a lot of the firepower, it's pretty much game over. And he walks off into the sunset with the skeletons. You notice the skeletons, they don't get distracted by the hoplites, so that's a huge benefit to that. So you see the breakdown tower. Archimedes Towers did a lot of work here, and look at, there's the Afro monument chipping in a big chunk of damage as well. And then I'll just real quick, I'll show you my replay against him, just so you get some offensive action here. I had wonderful help here. I had seven sisters, I believe, on this one. And here's his base, heavily stacked Athena base theme. Athena's, her houses are probably arguably, top two, top three houses to have around your base, because they buff, the barracks, which in turn buffs all your spawners, and of course they buff the health of all your buildings, making all your buildings hard to kill. So they're definitely a great house. Although when you have this many of them around and it does go down, then it obviously weakens and opens up a lot of holes in the base. So I pretty much employ the slow roll strategy. So of course the Apollo monument is like my main target right off the bat. That way I don't have to worry about all my little helpers and even the adds that I'm getting killing them. So if you're helping out, or if you're getting assists and you notice, you definitely want to put a priority on taking out the Apollo monument, because it just destroys your hoplites and all of your helpers. So make that a top priority. So I'm working into the Athena temple here. Just controlling, adding, pulling back, got the slow time to make sure I got control of all of the extra troops. His barracks are reasonably well upgraded. Now I'm just kind of rolling around the perimeter to finish off the last couple temples here. Generally speaking, you want to stay out of the middle of most bases, just because you're getting surrounded by not only troops, but you're getting surrounded by towers and all that as well. So generally, I go around the perimeter of bases, especially employing this strategy to kind of take them out and then break them down. And yeah, I just made, with the amount of this much help, I pretty much couldn't fail. I couldn't. So I think my gods were almost full health after that heal, and I just sat in fire here, which is always a bad idea. But yeah, I knew it was game over, GG. So you can see, I took very minimal damage and easily wiped him out with all the help here. All right, I'm gonna discuss my layout real quick. I did mention it in the replay video, but I'm gonna highlight a few key features of the base. So of course, all of my towers that depend on range or benefit from range, I have next to the greenhouses, along with the row of Archimedes. Then on the Aries houses side, I have the two buildings that would benefit from the Aries. I could switch the Aries monument and put it over there, but I do prefer the Athena monument just for the masses of troops. I think my Athena monument's upgraded slightly, whereas my Aries is, just baseline 1-1. And there's my Afro monument. You can see the range on it at 15, level 15. If I had it in the center of my base, it would charm anything pretty much, which I've thought about doing that, but I don't want to move my Artemis tower out of that key location because I do feel that it's a very beneficial target, and I want something in the center of my base to deter people just kind of skirting and doing the perimeter on it. So by putting it a little bit deeper towards the middle, I bring the attackers into the middle of my base. And then just the rest of the base is pretty standard. I spaced the three temples on one side, three temples on the other side, trying to avoid people going around the perimeter by putting my ballista towers on the perimeter here. And of course, I built on the edge of the map as much as possible here. I'm going to open up a few of these spots and then really put it in the corner so that way, really, I only have to worry about two sides of my map as far as the enemy using those to just get some breathing room and kite me. And then I can, worry about dealing that with maybe putting some more, spacing out some more towers and some other defense out here to kind of hammer them as they're walking around the perimeter. Because if they walk around this side, they're going to get hit. And there's not much room for error. If they make any mistakes, they're going to be in there. And of course, most of the Archimedes towers can hit them there, especially with the range buff. So that's a little bit about my base. Let's see if we got any action going on over here. AJ and Josh. Okay, so AJ and then Yep has a defense. So I always kind of prioritize attackers over defense. I know trophies at the top level, you want to help both as much as possible, but just purely from a resource standpoint, obviously you get a lot more resources from attacks, and that's when you're using your valuable resource of nectar. So I feel that, priority should, go to the guys that are attacking for help. Oh, look at, he didn't, I was too late to help him out. Sorry about that, AJ. But, yeah, like I was saying, prioritize helping attackers over defense, just generally speaking, because that's when you get your resources from battles. Even when you win a defense, you only get 80 to 100K. Obviously, the trophies matter, but attacks, you can see you get a ton of stone and you get more gold as well. So you definitely don't want to lose the attacks. If you lose a defense, no big deal. You have nothing to gain. That's one of the great aspects about the game. You don't lose anything when you lose, besides trophies, and that's not, anything that's gonna hurt you real bad, unless you're one of the guys trying to go for the top of the list here. Congrats to Kiva today, Keva. Keva that got rank 6, and we've got right now the top 10. We've got Pong, we've got Keva in Dream Team here. And actually, I just noticed that we hit rank number 1 just recently. A few people left Rising Gods, so we are number 1, the Dream Team right now. So congrats to the Alliance. Great group of guys. They really all help out. They have a lot of really active members that I'd say almost play, all their waking hours. There's a few guys like Pong and Yep, that are pretty much on all the time, from what I can tell. I don't know if they sleep or what, but that's a great asset to have, is a group of Alliance members that are very active and always there to help you when you want it. Here we are defending Yep's base. Yep is 6,000 cups here, and I think his defense is actually higher than his offense as far as his cup rating goes, so he's definitely one of the stronger bases. You can see it's well leveled up. I think almost everything is near max or A lot of buildings are max out here, and he has it very well spread out, so it prevents people from just zerging with the Ares bull charge, just annihilating a bunch of temples at one time. They really have to plan out their strategy. I think maybe Yep should maybe relocate the Afro temple to the middle here, because he's kind of got the cluster of temples down here, so that way it allows people to kind of skirt around and take out his main temples. You can see there's a million people following him right now, and I'm kind of slow because I'm talking here on resources, on reinforcements, I mean. But let's see if we can cut him off. A lot of people are, with the new move all button, it's been a lot better and a huge benefit to me as well to be able to control and move your gods. Because before, when you had to individually move your gods, that was a humongous pain. And the players that could do that really well really, kind of had a definite advantage over the players that weren't quite as skilled with their, god management. Now they make it definitely easier to manage your gods. And I definitely appreciate that. I think a lot of players have appreciated that as well. Well, I don't want to make this video too long, so I'm going to conclude at the end of this defensive replay. I just wanted to show you guys some game footage, a little bit of replays. Please feel free to ask any questions or post any comments you might have regarding anything you've seen, or anything you'd like me to talk about, or ideas you have, or even tips you have if you've seen some mistakes. Of course, just like everyone, I'm trying to improve all the time. I kind of been learning a lot from watching these guys in Dream Team. There's like, a handful of guys that are just really awesome attackers. So it's been great to watch them and get some tips and stuff from them. Okay, he's trying to get some Cerberus action going here, and you can see that we're down to the last temple, and I think he's gonna do it. He's got 28 seconds, and if long shot, yeah, just barely, got it, but finish it off. And I'm gonna see All right, well, thanks for tuning in, guys. Just doing a live action here. So I will record. I'd hope to be doing these more often. I got a headset, so now hopefully the audio and everything sounds better. I hope to be doing these, at least maybe a couple a week, and give you guys some footage. And then hopefully I'm gonna start focusing in on, highlighting some of the key players in the game and what they're doing and how they're doing it. All right, thanks for tuning in. Catch you in the next video. Keep leveling up.